Welcome back to the final part of this video tutorial series. In this video, we'll be showcasing how you can publish your experience to the web and also how you can access your web experience in the social apps to share it more broadly. We will be using the experience we built in the first three videos to showcase how we can publish it, but this video will also act as a standalone video to showcase how we can publish our immersive experience to the web and to social apps, including apps like Instagram and TikTok. So using the project that we created previously, we're actually going to head back to my.zap.works by clicking on the M menu and clicking Go Back to ZapWorks. Once we're back on my.zap.works, we'll be taken to our project overview page. If we came directly from Mattercraft, it will take us to the project that we were working on. You can also access any project overview page from your workspace via my.zap.works. The project overview page comes with a number of helpful features, including the ability to obviously open the tool that you're using, also triggers, which we're going to come back to in a second, the versions of your published project, and also analytics. Triggers are very important when you're publishing your experience. They're a way of actually distributing your content to your end users. In most cases, when you're using a face filter experience and distributing it to your users via only the web, a QR code trigger is perfect for that. You can also add new triggers to your project and your project overview page by clicking on the new trigger button. The two most important ones here for our web-based content are QR codes and deep links. A QR code trigger comes by default for each project on my.zap.works. However, because we're publishing to our social apps, we're going to add a deep link trigger, which gives us a URL that we can share, which will automatically redirect to our most up-to-date version of our project. So let's add a deep link now. As soon as a deep link is added, we'll see it in the trigger list and we can copy the URL. If we want to, we can also share our QR code by copying or downloading that from here. If we now take this URL and paste it into a browser, we'll see our most up-to-date experience run. The great thing about Mattercraft experiences, especially when you're using HTML elements, is that they're responsive to every screen size. This same project will work on a desktop and show the correct camera, and will also work on mobile devices. Another great thing about the project overview page is that it has analytics. So if we head back to that and scroll down, you'll see that now that we've launched our experience from our published trigger, the analytics will start to add up. We can also use this deep link trigger to share our immersive experience within the social apps. This allows for a broader reach. For example, if you wanted to share this via your TikTok profile, you can head into your profile settings, go to the website link, paste in this deep link trigger, click save, and this website link, which is your deep link trigger, will appear on your TikTok profile. You can then add posts to TikTok promoting your immersive experience that you can find in your website link. If your end user clicks on your website link in your profile, they will be launched into the default TikTok browser and the experience will be shown without them having to come out of the application, which broadens your reach and allows you to get more eyes on your experience without needing a marketing budget or having to manually promote your content. Now let's have a look at how we can do the same thing, but on Instagram. Instagram stories allow you to add a link which acts as a sticker. So on top of your story, add a sticker and find the link. You can then simply paste your deep link trigger into this link and click done. You can then style this and update the text to how you want it. As you can see, our story here is promoting our immersive web experience. And when we post this story, our end users can simply click on our deep link trigger from our story, and it will take them again directly into the default Instagram web browser without taking them directly out of the application. Again, this is a really nice and free way to promote your immersive web experience directly in social apps. You can also make use of this same method in any application that allows for a link to be added, meaning your same web experience can be viewed across all of the social apps and also on the default web browser of any device you share it to. This can really help increase the audience numbers that see your immersive web experience. One thing to note, if you ever want to make changes to your project, all you need to do is head into Mattercraft, make the changes, and click publish. Your deep link trigger will always redirect to your most up-to-date published version. So even if you have an active story and you find a bug, all you need to do is update that bug and click publish, and your end users will automatically see the most up-to-date version with the bug fix. This is one of the great things about the web and why we believe that in some cases, this method is better than using built-in effects on the social apps. Thank you so much for watching, and we can't wait to see what you build and share on the social applications.